with fairness, opportunity and democracy at its heart. A manifesto for a country that is welcoming and outward looking. A manifesto that reflects our belief in the infinite possibilities open to the people of Scotland if we work together in the common good to build the kind of country we know we can be. We know that decisions taken at Westminster in the years ahead will shape our country. So now, more than ever, it is vital to have strong SNP voices standing up for Scotland. With Labour... for many, many years to come. But with their true colours being exposed in this campaign, we have a real chance to keep them in check. And let us be clear, Labour isn't strong enough to do that. Voting Labour simply risks letting in Tory MPs. In Scotland, only the SNP can keep the Tories in check.
And after that, borrowing only to invest.
Secondly, to return the deficit to its pre-crash long-term average. Thirdly, to set debt on a downward path. These responsible fiscal targets will return the UK's finances to a stable and sustainable position. And crucially, they will also free up an additional £118 billion of public investment over the next Parliament to grow the economy, safeguard public services and protect household incomes. A clear alternative to 5 more years of austerity, hope and investment for the future, not another potential destroying cycle of cuts. That's the SNP plan.
Bodies,
that is based on a proper consideration of the impact of inflation, with a view to reaching fair outcomes that strike the right balance between affordability and the cost of living. And thirdly, the policies in this manifesto will restore fairness to our social security system. Make no mistake, the Tories have sought to undermine faith in the welfare state itself. They have set out very deliberately to stigmatise those on benefits. Of course, no one should be allowed to abuse the system, but their rhetoric is cover for the hardship they are causing to those who work hard and struggle to get by on low incomes. Children, the elderly, women, the disabled, even the bereaved are bearing the brunt. There are around £9 billion in social security cuts still to come over the next 4 years. Not surprisingly, the Tories want to press ahead with every single penny. What is surprising is that Labour is pledging to reverse less than a quarter of those cuts. So let me be clear today, SNP MPs will stand against all of the further planned cuts to social security. Our shared ambition for the future of our nation.